Every time since we've been together in the house. I'll say to Josh, I continue to remember to pray for us. But yeah, thank God the Holy Spirit is there to remind us. God is there to teach us all the time. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes, hallelujah. Our psalm reading for today will come from Psalms 29, the Psalm of David. Ascribe to the Lord, you heavenly beings. Ascribe to the Lord, glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord, due to his name. Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory. The God of glory thunders. The Lord thunders over the mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is majestic. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks in pieces the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon leap like a calf, Syria like a wild horse. The voice strikes with flashes of lightning. The voice of the Lord shakes the desert. The Lord shakes the desert of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord twists the ox and strips the forest bare. And in his temple, all high glory. The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord is enthroned as king forever. The Lord gives strength to his people. The Lord blesses his people with peace. Hallelujah. The Lord gives strength to his people. And the Lord blesses his people with peace. Bless the Lord.
Amen. be exalted in our lives. We offer ourselves unto you this morning, Lord.
Thank you so much.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Well, good morning, everybody. I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. It's good to be in church.
Yes.
Amen. Praise God. Welcome, everybody. Greetings, Pastor Henry. Good to see you, sir. Greetings to the whole church. It's good to be back in church.
Yes.
Amen. It's good to be back in church. So good.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. It's good to be back.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Well, this morning, I want to speak to you about choices. I want to speak to you about choices. We all have a choice to make.
Yeah.
Amen. And I want to encourage you to join me in the book of Deuteronomy at chapter number 30. Somebody say choices.
Choices.
Hallelujah. It's a choice. Thank you, Father. When you there, you say amen. Hallelujah. Are you there? Deuteronomy 30. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Are you there?
Amen.
Deuteronomy 30, amen. And I want you to read verse number 19 on the top of your voice. 1, 2, go. One more time, at the top of your voice.
I declare and confess goodness today against you, that I have set before you the life and death, blessings and curses, therefore comes life, that both you and your death may life.
Amen. So this is Moses speaking to Israel. I believe it's very applicable to us today. He says, I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you.
Yeah.
So praise God. We have a witness in heaven.
Thank you, Lord.
I say we have a witness in heaven. So he says, I call heaven and earth as a witness today against you, that I have set before you life and death. See that? I said, life and death have been set before you. That's what he said. Life and death have been set before you. Blessing and cursing. So you have life and death set before you. And you have blessing and cursing, which have also been set before you. That means the table has been set. The table has been laid. Now that it has been set, he says, therefore choose life.
Thank you.
So you have a choice to make. You can either choose death or you can choose life.
Right.
You can choose the blessing or you can choose the curse. It's an individual choice. But praise God, Moses prompts the nation of Israel to choose life. Because in life there is blessing. Jesus in John 10:10 says, the thief comes except to steal, kill, and destroy. But I have come that you might have life and have it more abundantly. In other words, you got to choose life. The day you choose Jesus, you choose life and you receive life. tries to drain that life out of you. How? He uses the media. He uses every means possible. And prevent you from truly living and experiencing this abundant life. Hallelujah.
Yes.
You know, I thank God. I was speaking to Pastor Sharon this week. We were listening, talking. And we were talking to Pastor Sharon's parents over the phone. And we said, we thank God that for this entire period of lockdown, God has had His hand upon us.
Amen.
We thank God.
Yeah.
You know, we went every way. We've been to so many places. We could have picked up this thing.
Mm-hmm.
But every time before we leave the house, we pray.
Yeah.
We plead the blood of Jesus.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. When you see, God gives you His word, He gives you His laws, His principles for you to live by. The Bible says they overcame Him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. What are you speaking? What are you speaking? Are you speaking what the world is speaking? and spread it. Spread it. I'm reminded in the book of Judges, chapter 15, where the Philistines, they made a trick on Samson. And then Samson goes back. He goes back to his father-in-law's house for his wife. And when he gets there, his father-in-law has given his wife to another man. And then Samson says, I will be guiltless of what will happen to the Philistines. I'm here to tell you this morning, it doesn't matter what the enemy has taken from you. It's time you came back. It's time.
Or to disobey God.
Cain and Abel virtuous. Present unto God an honorable sacrifice, or a dishonorable one. Hence we see God accepts and receives the one, and rejects, despises the other. It's a hard thing. Cain had a choice. Either to accept that his brother offered a better sacrifice for him, or to continue the way that he went, where he despised him and killed him. You have a choice with your mouth. You can choose to speak life to somebody or to kill him with your words. You see that? Sometimes your words are daggers. You can use your word to cut off what is ungodly from the life of someone by speaking life, speaking blessing, speaking peace. Or you can use it to stab him in the back. No one had a choice to make. I need to obey God. And as foolish as it seemed to build an ark, to build a ship in the middle of a desert, which was far away from the sea, I need to obey God. But to disobey God, and watch how the flood would wash him and his entire family, together with the nations that they were with the youth, wash away. He had a choice. He chose life. Abraham had a choice. Either to stay in his father's house and think like his father and worship the pagan gods that his father worshipped, or to come out from among them, from earth of the champions, and to go to the place that God was leading him to. He had a choice.
He says, Father, if you are willing,
you can remove this cloud from you. There are many things, probably you this morning, you've probably been praying, Father, remove this thing from me. But Jesus knew that the will of God is greater than his will. Will of the Father. He submitted himself to the will of the Father. And he said, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. We pray the Our Father. We just sang that song this morning. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. His will is what matters most, not our will. Even when we pray, we never pray our will. We pray His will. We never speak our will. We speak His will. Come on, somebody. I mean, some sisters, when they pray, even brothers, when they pray, you feel like you can dictate to God how to change your spouse, how to change your spouse. I should leave it there in your spice, because you want your spouse to be your spice, to your life. But you don't pray to say, Father, mold my spouse to be the person you created them to be. We pray for our children, mold my child to be the person you created them to be. You know what, we don't do that. We rob them of their true potential. We rob them of their true identity. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sometimes we, because we couldn't achieve things in our lives, we want to live our lives out through our children. So everything that you didn't achieve, you push it on your child for your child to achieve it. Forgetting that your child is a unique individual created by God.
Sickness is on the curse.
You buy a loaf of bread. Let's say you pay 15 rand for that bread. And the cashier would tell you, excuse me, sir, you still owe me 15 rand. I've seen some folk in the supermarket. They start opening up their sleeves. Excuse me. Now, some sisters, they roll up the skirts. Excuse me. You're ready to fight because you know it's been paid for already. That's the same with our healing. You need to get to a point where you say it has been paid for already. I'm saved by virtue of the price that Jesus paid. I don't need to pay anything anymore because Christ paid it all. The last words of the cross were, "It is finished, it is finished, it is finished." You can choose to be rich or you can choose to be poor. It's the truth. Don't come and tell me I was born into a poor family. If you look at most of the successful football players, it's amazing the most successful football player couldn't even afford a pair of soccer boots. He played barefoot. The most successful soccer player didn't even have a ball, yet he's the most successful. So quit blaming your background. Quit blaming your parents. Quit blaming society. Quit blaming the government. Blame yourself. Blame yourself. Blame yourself. Blame yourself. The thing is, which mirror are you looking into? Are you looking into the one that is man-made that you see and you see yourself there? Or are you looking to the perfect law?
So important that you need to make wise choices.
relying on the Holy Spirit. Pray about it. Pray about it. Hallelujah. If you must, get a prayer partner to pray with you about the Savior. In Matthew 18, verse 19, Jesus tells us, if two of you agree on earth as touching anything, it shall be so. So look, there is power in the prayer of agreement. Hallelujah. I'm speaking to some spouses this morning. Maybe it's time you stop walking in disagreement and you start walking in agreement. Hallelujah. It's time you stop walking in disagreement and you start walking in agreement. The Bible says, can two walk together unless they be in agreement? Hallelujah. That's what you find in a home. The enemy discourages married couples from praying. Because one puts 1,000 to flight, but two put 10,000 to flight. You see that? There's great power in a praying couple. There's great power in a praying family. Remember Joshua, in the book of Joshua 24, verse 15, he says, you choose today whom you will serve, but as for me and my house, you need to get to the point where you say, you can choose what you want, but as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. We will serve the Lord. Hallelujah. Point number two, refer to the Word. The Word of God. Every choice that you need to make, its answer is in the Word. The answer to everything in life is found in the Scriptures. Go to the Word of God, find it. Find it. This is real treasure. It's better than rubies. Come on, somebody. Just find the finest silver that you will find in the Word of God. I remember a few years back, they used to have these banners. You remember those banners? WWJD, what would Jesus do? Mm-hmm. Everybody just wanted because it was like a fashion. But how many really stop to say, I'm faced with this decision. I'm faced with this choice. What would Jesus do? Let me see. Go for the Word. It's point number two. Hallelujah. Deuteronomy 30, verse 14, Moses speaks to Israel and he says to them, but the word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart, that you may do it. The word is so near. The same scripture is echoed in the book of Romans, chapter number 8. The word is near you, in your mouth and in your heart. Go for the word. Point number three, never let fear or anger be the deciding factor. Never let fear or anger be the deciding factor. Ephesians 4 tells us, don't let the sun go down on your anger. Hallelujah. The book of Proverbs tells us, the wicked flee when nobody pursues, but the righteous are bold as a lion. It's about Jesus. It's not about what the people say. Sometimes people are afraid of what people will say. Let me tell you something. If they don't put bread and butter on your table, if they don't pay for the roof over your head, then your burden doesn't matter. Jesus. God puts the bread and butter on my table. God pays for the roof over my head. His burden matters more. Come on, somebody.
Some of you shopaholics, you tell that sales.
busy. Don't be too busy. Take your time. Point on the Savior. Don't be double-minded or powerful. Don't be double-minded. Once your mind is made up, stick to it. Look at Peter, God out of that boat. He walked on the water. And all of a sudden, he looked at Jesus, he looked at the waters, he looked at the sea. He saw the world. You cannot look at the world and the one who calls the world at the same time. You're going to give in to the other world. And if you look to the one who calls the world, if you look to him, I say, if you look to him, if you look to him, you will win the storm. If you look to him, yes, those winds may blow. Those waves may become boisterous. May become rough. But praise God, in Jesus, you are tough. In Jesus, you are tough. Say amen to God. Lastly, once it lines up with the word, stick to your guns. Once you found the word, concerning that decision, concerning that choice, once you found it, and the decision you made lines up with the word, stick to your guns. Obey the word. Obey the word. You remember Moses? Remember Moses? God told Moses to stand in front of the rock. Now Moses wanted to come up. You remember that? What did Moses do? He struck the rock. He struck the rock with his rod. He struck it. Because he got angry. You see anger? You see anger? A moment of anger can cost you your life. A moment of anger. You got angry, took his rod, beat the rock. And what did God do? When they got to Mount Nebo, God told Moses, Moses, can you see Canaan? Can you see the land? Can you see the land? Can you see Canaan? Can you see the promised land? Can you see my promise? My promise is about to be fulfilled. You just need to cross over. It's right there, Moses. But Moses, because you disobeyed me, you'll die. You'll die. You see that? You have a choice to make. Life is based on choices. If you choose to drop out of school, if you choose to drop out, I'm speaking to some young children this morning. Don't drop out because of the teacher. Don't drop out because of what the teacher said. Don't drop out because of what society is saying. You finish school. You get your education. And when you finish with your matric, you go on and you learn. It's only going to take you 3 years. You sacrifice 3 years after school. But it will be well worth it. It will be well worth it. And even when you finish school, that's when you really experience life. And you see that life, it's like more difficult. It's more challenging. It doesn't matter how great those challenges are. I'm speaking to our young people of South Africa. Hold on to Jesus. Hold on to Jesus. Hold on to the promises of God. He lifts you up out of that circumstance. He lifts you up out of it. The Bible says weeping may endure for a moment, but the joy of the Lord comes in the morning. Your morning will come. Your morning will come. Jacob wrestled. He wrestled all night. And the one whom he wrestled with said, let go of me, for the day is about to break. He says, I won't leave you until you bless me. I won't leave you until you bless me. You see, when your morning is about to break, that's the most important. Most people give up. hour like the rest of the world. Or you can choose to live in faith. Yes, things have changed in our lives. We wear masks. We sanitize in our hands. Have you ever thought for 1 second and said, well, praise God, at least now we're more clean than we used to be?
Jesus. There are countries where they cannot even own or possess the Bible.
You and I have that freedom and that liberty, but do we use it? No. You know, when you study the life of Israel, because you understand, when you consider the life of Israel, you find in the book of Psalms, there's a psalm that Israel sang, they prayed unto God concerning the welfare of Israel and the king. When last did you pray for our state president? When last did you pray for the welfare of our country? Are we talking like the clouds? Or are we going to take the word and start speaking the word? We see a South Africa that has changed. We see a nation that's on fire for God. We see young people that honor their parents. Not yes. You may see it with your natural eye. Don't speak what you see in your natural. Speak what you see according to the word of God. He says the fruit of your womb will be blessed. Don't speak curses over your children. Speak blessing. Speak blessing over your grandchildren and your great-grandchildren. Come on, somebody. Speak life. Choose life this morning. Amen.
Amen.
I trust you receive something this morning. I trust you receive something this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Come on, somebody shout the name of Jesus in this name. Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Well, as we close, I'm going to call Pastor Sharon to the offering. Okay. The protocol that is there. After the offering, we will exit the church. That entrance will not exit the same way we came with this. That exit. And at the exit, there's the offering box where you can put in the tidy offering, sanitize your hands, and please don't engage too much. Remember social distancing, but leave each other with the alcohol. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Amen. Next week, Sunday, I want to encourage you. You want to have communion.
Amen.
So I want to encourage you to bring communion from your home. Remember protocol observed, right? Bring communion from your home. And we have communion together as a family next week, Sunday.
Amen.
Come on, give the Lord praise.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. We serve a mighty God this morning.
Amen.
He is the King of Kings and He is the Lord of Lords.
Yes.
Hallelujah. This morning, I want to read for you from the book of Malachi. Everybody knows Malachi 3, verse from verse 7. And the Bible reads, even from the days of your fathers, ye are gone away from mine ordinances, and have not kept them. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, said the Lord of hosts. But ye said, wherein shall we return? Now this the answer, will a man rob God? Yet ye have robbed me. But you say, where have we robbed thee? In tithes and offerings. You are cursed with a curse, for you have robbed me, even this whole nation. Bring ye the tithes to the storehouse, that they may be meat in mine house, and prove me now with your word, says the Lord of hosts. If I will not open you the windows of heaven, and pour out a blessing, that they shall not be room enough to receive it, hallelujah. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sakes, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground, neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time in the field, says the Lord of hosts. And all nations shall call you blessed, for you shall be a delightsome land, says the Lord of hosts, hallelujah. Everything here is in this chapter, hallelujah. The way we should live this life, hallelujah, we must start to understand there's no preparation, there's no sermon for this. Because the Holy Spirit said to me, I asked him, guide me, what is this about? And you know what? We are supernatural. Until we come to understand, like I said, you cannot prepare this message. Because you've got to understand you're supernatural. Even in this last hour, understand, when you come to that understanding, brothers and sisters, I can't explain give up and faint. I mean, when I think that, you know, I can never make it. But we can make it, because we serve a supernatural God. And we start to understand we are supernatural beings. I think we haven't come to that understanding that these are not the dark times for the children of God. We serve a great God. It is wonderful to serve Him. It is wonderful to come to the house of the Lord. It is wonderful to give to God so the work of God can go on and on. That's what God says, so that they may meet in my house. Hallelujah. We praise the Lord for what He has done for us. We honor what this mighty God. Can we stand to our feet? Hallelujah. If you want to, it's okay. Can we bow our heads and close our eyes? Dear Father God, we thank you, Jesus. Oh Lord, that we serve such a supernatural God. Oh Lord Jesus, a God that is everywhere. Lord Jesus, oh God. Oh Lord Jesus, oh God. You take time for each and every individual, oh God. You know us by our name, Jesus, oh God. You know the number of hairs on our head, Jesus. Oh Lord, you know our thoughts and intents, oh God. That is why I always say, Father, before we even utter words, Lord, before we even think thoughts, help us, Lord, that we analyze our thoughts, our words, that be pleasing before you, Jesus. Because whatever we speak is death and life. That we can be mindful of our ways, of our character. And Lord, that we can be people, oh Father, that serve you in power, that we speak life all the time. Whenever we speak death, Father, Spirit is there for comfort. His Holy Spirit picks you up in the midst of every moment of the day. You can count on the power of the Holy Spirit. He is a merciful God. Thank you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. We worship you now and we give you all.
Church of God's name.